Hey there, and welcome to the ODU Library's instructional videos. I'll be showing you a few important tips about keywords, word connectors, and truncation that will improve your results when searching academic databases. Google is great for research, but sometimes we can run into trouble when we search databases in the same way. Follow these tips to get better results in a shorter amount of time. So let's pretend we've picked a topic and want to find sources on the effects of teenage cell phone use on driving. We could Google this entire sentence, but here's what happens when we do that in an academic database. Zero results. We'll get better results if we only use words that are relevant and unlikely to show up all over the written material. So the only relevant keywords for this topic are teenagers, cell phones, and driving. Sometimes it's useful to surround phrases of two or more words like cell phones in quotes. This tells the database to search for that exact term. We also want to avoid words that are too common to be helpful. Words like effect, impact, and cause are considered stop words and won't be searched, so avoid including them. So now we know what words to include in our search, the next step is combining them with connectors. Keyword connectors tell the database how to combine your terms to either narrow or expand a search. They are and, or, and not. If we were to search just for the phrase cell phone, we'd find that it appears in over 150,000 results. The term driving appears in over 3 million, and teenagers over 300,000. So if we connect these terms with and, it'll focus the results by searching for resources that include all of the words. More and connectors obviously mean fewer results. Let's try this out in a good multidisciplinary database, Academic Search Complete. When we search all three without the and connector, we get one result because the database automatically executed the search as a phrase. All databases differ in small ways, so check their help pages if something isn't working the way you expect it to. Trying the search again, but adding and between the words, gives us a much more manageable 41 results. And a good way to remember this is that and will always narrow your search, and the opposite, the or connector, will always broaden them because it allows you to include synonyms. For example, a term similar to teenagers might be adolescents. And we could do two searches simultaneously by using or, cell phone and teenagers, or cell phone and adolescents. Pay more attention when using both types of connectors. You need to put the synonyms grouped with or in parentheses to tell the search which operations to run first. Let's look at our search results. This time we found all the articles that included the phrase cell phone and either teenager or adolescent. The last connector is not. If you see results that focus on a topic you are not interested in, using not before a term can be useful. For example, if I don't want to read about drinking and driving, I can do this. Teenage and cell phone, not drinking. Everything mentioning the word drinking will be removed. Another way to broaden your search terms is to truncate them using the asterisk symbol. Truncation can save you time by searching for many variations of the keyword at once. Our keyword driving is a good candidate for this. Instead of the whole word, I'll type drive using an asterisk in place of the end of the word. Now the database will find multiple types of the word, such as driving and drivers. But beware, if you put your truncation in the wrong place, you can get back the wrong results. Shortening drive too early can result in words like drinking or drill. Okay, so you won't use all of these techniques with every database search, but use them when you need to. Thanks for watching, and if you want help with any part of the research process, visit our website at odu.edu/library.